you heard about the nodule business. Stefano showed you nicely how you can use the EBOscope in various indications to diagnose lesions and to stage lung cancer patients. All those scopes we have in our hands since a couple of years, and we have seen new versions. So we have seen a smaller EBOscope. And now what is next? Now it's a great pleasure, as mentioned, we will present you a next platform we have can use to increase the possibility combining digital technologies and the perfect scopes from Olympus. So again, it's me, you have heard me before, and it's now really a pleasure to show you the next platform you can use to handle your scopes. I will go through the different modalities. I will show you the next bronchoscopes you can order to the new machine, and I will give you some insights why I believe that the new platform will help us in our daily doing to increase our yield. So that's the new system. So CV1500, now you see it for the first time. So that's everything. So it's the light source, it's the processor. So everything is included in one machine. And like you normally know from your smartphones, everything is steerable by the touch screen. So no need for keyboards anymore. And for the first time, Olympus was able to combine their two worlds. So even Asia, UK can use it as the Europeans. So we used in the past different series, but now everything is in one single processor. For the light, we are using LED lights, and we have five different LEDs using what we normally doing, but there's also a new wavelengths we use is amber. I will show you later why we need that. And with this little machine, you can have a lot of fancy technologies. So what is brightness adjustment? What we all knowing when you have your scope into in the airways, then you see what is in your near field. But when you really want to have a look deeper in the system, it's normally a black spot, and you have to move that scope in the direction of the black spots that you really have better visualization of the depth. So normally you focus on your near field, but with the new option with BAI, you are able to increase the visibility even in the deeper part of the lungs. So you see that even here in the still image. So due to a brightness adjustment, it's easier for you to see when you look to the main carina, like in that image, what is happening maybe in the depth, so you can focus more on the depth. You don't have to maneuver your scope so often and you center it, and you really have a better visualization what happens in the deeper part of the lung. It's a quite simple technology because you only have to press the button and then you have it. But it's super complicated what happens in the machine or what happens in the backup of your system. So you press the button and you have the new mode active. These are the details behind. You have your original imaging. The machine makes an analysis of the brightness, makes an analysis of the texture. Then he corrects the brightness and you see the image again. So I believe that brightness adjustment really will help you to have a better visualization in the deeper part of the lung. So we hope that we can reduce the procedure time by that, and we really have a better visualization from parts which are really black at the moment for us. Just to show you that in bigger way, this is the system on the off, press the off button. So you see, you know where you want to move your scope forward, but it's still dark in the depths. Now pressing the button, making the mode on, and then you see it's way brighter in the depths. You have a better visualization from the deeper parts of the lung. So quite helpful. We in Heidelberg are in the luxury situation that we have the system already for testing, and this is really something which makes fun. You really see quickly deeper into the lung. So the next is the TXI, so texture and color enhancement imaging. And it's a little bit the same what you do nowadays when you use your smartphone and you take a photo, and then every app offers you a solution that automatically the image will be better. So you get more contrast, you have more colors, and then it even looks brighter when you just add that mode. It's a little bit the same. And the big advantage for me is in that image that you have the feeling that you get a more three-dimensional view. It's not a two-dimensional view. We have really the feeling it's a little more three-dimensional when you activate that button. Even therefore, behind, it's a super tricky algorithm. Again, you have your normal white light image, and again, the machine makes you an analysis of the texture, analyze you different details, analyze you the color, and then you have two modes which you can activate, and then you see, depending if you want to have more color enhancement, if you want to have more texture, do you see different modalities of that TXI, and it gives you really a better visualization of the endobronchial image. Here again, the comparison, the white light, and then you have TX1 and TX2, and the idea behind is to give you a better view how it really looks inside the lung. Ralph Eberhardt and we're still debating who prefers TX1, who prefers the two mode. So we have to figure it out, but it's really fascinating how much you can change from the visualization when you really activate that mode. And for me, the most fancy issue is that you really have the feeling of a three-dimensional image. And again, you combine it automatically with the brightness adjustment. So all that additional options you have by that, you can combine with the TXE 1 or 2 mode. And the last is the RDI, the red dichromatic imaging, and therefore we need amber. Therefore we need the LED number 5, because for all of you who have been involved in NBI and NBI imaging, knowing that we're seeing the upper surface a little bit better, that we can see the vessels a little bit better, we learned that, and we're getting it automatically in every new scope since we have the technique available. The problem of NBI always was that it's limited by the penetration into the mucosa. And therefore, by combining an additional wavelength, this is amber, we have, due to the penetration of that wavelength into the tissue, the possibility to visualize a little bit more of the mucosa, so to looking a little bit deeper into the epithelium. And again, these are the images. Again, you have to press a button. This is the white light mode. And then you press the RDI mode, and then you see the vascularization. It's a little bit better. You see it better than in the white light. And some of you have the feeling, okay, that looks a little bit like NBI, maybe a little bit more greener. But what you then can do next, you also can then change the enhancement, and then it gets plastic again. So therefore you see the different modalities. You have the brightness adjustment, you have NBI is still there, but the RDI might be the new NBI, because you really can see more deep details in the depths, and then you have the TX X1 or TX2, which really can help you to get a more three-dimensional feeling of the bronchial airways. So these are the main features. I just want to show you two. For sure, you can zoom the image, but this is what we expected because that was already possible with the last system. So you have to press a button, zoom 1.0, 1.2, 1.5. You see the examples below. And maybe Stefano, as the expert, already realized it. Hey, what the hell is that image? Where are the black spots at the corner? Now, Olympus also offers you the option that you have a full screen image. So you can change that, the same view, first with the small black corner. So this is the classical view. Stefan and I, we are such old guys. We have seen, we have started with the bronchoscope with fiber optics, where you have seen a lot of dots and a black ring around. Then we move to the digital area. Now we have had black spots only at the corner, but nowadays we're getting rid of the black spots. So we have a full screen image, and that really gives you a better visualization of the whole system. And it's up to you if you want to see it classical or if you want it in the full screen mode. So this is the processor, but you also can have new scopes for that. There are two new scopes available, the 1100 and the 1200 series. And what are the features of that new system? First of all, for the first time, these are small scopes with huge working channels. Yeah? So the 1100, the distal tip is 4.9, so below 5, and the working channel is 2.2. So big, you can insert everything what you can get. You can put the radial EBO through with a guide sheet. You can put needles and forceps and cryoprobes down. And also you can put down the upcoming ablation technology through that working channel. For sure, the scope have all the other options we're knowing, and this is the bigger brother, the one who has a bigger outer diameter, 5.8, but has a 3 millimeter working channel, which is really an advantage, because knowing a little bit what is coming next, we will have in our hands a couple of techniques in the near future, which needing a working channel which is bigger than 2.8 millimeters, not for cancer, for other diseases, but we need scopes which have a normal outer diameter, but a bigger working channel. And Siri, which is visible here, has a 3 millimeter working channel, which is really quite helpful for our daily doing. And for sure, like in the last series already, we have the rotation function. And there have been a couple of publications showing that when you can rotate the working channel, that it's easier for you. You don't have to bend yourself or bend your hands around you, that you really reach the upper lobes or the B6 segments. And especially for the nurses, it's quite supportive when they don't have to move around you to help you to insert something into the working channel. So the rotation function, I think since the last series, it's a standard, and even the rotation function is adapted to the new scope series. So what are the impacts of the new system, to come closely to the end? So what we getting in our hands now is a new illumination of the far field. We can work on the texture and the color enhancement with a specific mode. We have, with the RDI, we have a technology looking a little bit more in the depths of the bronchial mucosa. Combining that with the new versions of the scope, we have better ergonomic to the rotation function. Due to the bigger working channels, we can increase the suction capacity. I believe we can insert bigger tools, which is more important. And we also have now a small scope with a big diameter that we can do everything. So there are a lot of advantages of the new system, as well as of the new scope series. And therefore, I believe with all the new options we have in working on the image quality, improving the image quality with the help of digital analysis and improvement options, activating by the button, we will improve our imaging performance. We will have better visualization of accessible areas. And by improving everything, we will for sure, hopefully improving our diagnostic performance. And this is clearly the way we have to move forward with interventional pulmonology. We will also improve our therapeutic performance. So summarizing my talk, it was a great pleasure to show you for the first time the new system. Originally, it was a big party plan, but now COVID killed us the party. It was only up to me now to show you what is new. So system is super easy to use because you only have to press the button. You only have to have one machine, not two machines anymore. By having bigger working channels, it's safe from a patient perspective because we can suck out whatever we want. And I think especially the ergonomic support by the rotation function and even only one cable and all those features are really helpful for the whole team who works in the endoscopic unit. Therefore, I believe the next success story from Olympus starting now with the launch of the new system. So therefore, thanks a lot for your attention and have fun with the new system.